my lap, dude. Come on.
Welcome to our veterans program 2022. This time I'd like to introduce your MCs for this event, Peter Weir and Jane Wing.
Sympathy with peace and justice in the councils of nations.
I would like to welcome our students, staff, community members, families, and especially those who have served or are serving in the military to our program this morning. Welcome.
I'm here today to tell you a little about the folding of an American flag. Have you ever seen the traditional folding of the American flag? Have you ever wondered why the flag is folded that way? The flag is folded 13 times to represent the original 13 colonies of the United States. Each fold also carries its own important meaning. To name a few folds, the first one is a symbol of life. The third fold is made in honor of the veteran departing our ranks and who gave a portion of his or her life for the defense of our country. The sixth fold is for where our hearts lie. It is with our heart that we pledge our allegiance to the United States of America. The seventh fold is a tribute to our armed forces, for it is through the armed forces that we protect our country and our flag against all enemies. The eighth fold is a tribute to honor our mother, for whom the flag flies for on Mother's Day. The tenth fold is a tribute to the father, for he has given his sons and daughters for the defense of our country. The last fold, when the flag is completely folded, the stars are uppermost, reminding us of our national motto, "In God We Trust." When the flag is completely folded and tucked in, it takes on the appearance of a hat, representing the soldiers who served under George Washington, the sailors and Marines who served under John Paul Jones, and the many who followed in their footsteps. There are also typically three fired cartridges that are placed onto the folded flag prior to presentation to the next of kin. The cartridges signify duty, honor, and sacrifice. Next time you look at a beautifully folded flag, I hope that you will remember the love and care that went into each fold and for whom that flag was folded for. At this time, we would like to invite our sixth grade readers up to explain the branches of the armed forces.
There are six main branches of the military, including the Army, Air Force, Navy, Marine Corps, Coast Guard, and the Space Force.
Army. The Army is the main ground force and largest branch of the military. The Army's job is to control and fight on land using land troops, tanks, and artillery.
Air Force. The Air Force is part of the military that fights using aircraft, including fighter planes and bombers. The Air Force is part of the military, part of the Army, up until 1947 when it was made into its own branch. The Air Force is also responsible for military satellites in space.
Navy. The Navy fights in the oceans and seas throughout the world. The Navy uses all sorts of battleships, including destroyers, aircraft carriers, and submarines. The U.S. Navy is significantly larger than any other navy in the world and is armed with 10 of the world's 20 aircraft carriers as of 2014.
Marine Corps. The Marines are responsible for delivering task forces on land, at sea, and in the air. The Marines work closely with the Army, Navy, and Air Force. As America's expeditionary force in readiness, the U.S. Marines are forward deployed in an effort to win battles swiftly and aggressively in times of crisis.
Coast Guard. The Coast Guard is separate from the other branches as it is part of the Department of Homeland Security. The Coast Guard is the smallest of the military branches. It monitors the U.S. coastline and enforces border laws as well as helps with ocean rescues. The Coast Guard can be part of the Navy during times of war.
Space Force, the newest branch of the military. And the U.S. Space Force was signed into law in December 2019. Space Force organizes, trains, and equips space forces in order to protect U.S. and allied interests in space and to provide space capabilities in the joint force.
thank our veterans for their service by performing a tribute to the armed services arranged by Lloyd Larson. We ask that you stand when you hear your branch of song, service song performed. I would like to introduce our guest speaker, Sergeant First Class Travis Mockler.
Thank you for having me here today. Thank you, Deb Yeager, for the invite, and all of you who have helped organize this, this celebration. It's an honor to come back to Cadott to speak to you today. I've not put this uniform on in about 10 years, but it brings me great pride. It's a little tight, so I'll keep this short. First off, I need to say thank you to all the veterans in the audience today. Men, women, served in all branches of the military. I know there are a lot of Cadott alum who served before me, alongside me, and have served and deployed since my retirement. Not everyone here today had the choice to sign up, so to those people, I am most thankful for. I also want to thank the families of the veterans, spouses, moms and dads. I'm not very far into this, so it's going to be hard. Children, siblings, grandparents, what they have to endure when their loved ones go off to train or serve overseas is pretty immense. The constant thought of your loved one's safety and not coming home. A little about myself, I'm Travis Mockler. Graduated Cadott, 1990. I grew up between Cadott and Chippewa Falls on the land my mom and dad still live on. I had a pretty average life. I was a pretty average student. I had lots of friends. I did not go without. Some of you know my grandfather, Doc Center, who was a small town doctor right here in Cadott for most of his life. Grandpa lived very frugally and loved to take care of others. He offered all of his grandkids help with college money if they chose to attend college. Well, I received a postcard when I was 16 saying that the Army would pay for my college tuition and I could be all that I could be. Sounded pretty awesome. I could pay my own way through college and have a little spending money on the side. I mean, it's just stateside duty, right? My dad just missed the draft and didn't really have a lot of family that served, so when I told my parents I wanted to join the Army, they probably thought I was a little crazy. I joined the Wisconsin Army National Guard in February 1989. A week after I turned 17 years old, I did my split training option and completed my basic combat training between my junior and senior year in high school. I completed my advanced individual training the summer after. Even with all my college funding options, I was not ready for college. I worked a civilian job, worked part-time in the Wisconsin Army National Guard. As the years went by, I continued to re-enlist, and my plan was 20 years in retirement. Even after the towers fell, the likelihood of our unit being deployed seemed very slim. When the U.S. entered the Iraq War in 03, I still didn't realize how close we were to a deployment. Our training continued to ramp up until we got the call to deploy. Shortly before the deployment, I tore my ACL and had surgery. I could not deploy with the 1128 with Mr. Rothbauer over here, Michael Butterbro, Graham Buss, and others from Cadott. I recovered and got assigned to the 2 of the 127th in Appleton for their deployment. I deployed with Company A to the Kuwait-Iraq border to run convoy security from August 2005 to August 2006. That was my family for the year. No days off, you spend Thanksgiving, Christmas, your birthday with your military family. I was deployed with Brent Stelzer, Travis Sontag, and others from Cadott that year. I watched Brent get his Purple Heart pinned to his chest. Not everyone came back from Wisconsin after that deployment. My second deployment was with B Company 1128 in New Richmond. I was then detached to Delta Company 1128 to transport detainees to their court hearings from one detention facility to another, and throughout Baghdad and Iraq. We lived on the north side of Baghdad International Airport. I had a 60-man platoon, which was about double the normal platoon. We transported detainees, many from the deck of cars, on up-armored trucks, buses, aircraft, including Chinooks. This part-time stateside soldier from Cadott experienced a lot of things in country that I could never have imagined. I retired in July of 2010. After 21 and a half years as an E-7 Sergeant First Class from 1128th Infantry Battalion, headquartered in Eau Claire. In 2012, I went to the VA hospital for a chronic cough. I never smoked. It was really not enough to determine anything. Antibiotics didn't work. Nothing really could do for it. In 19, I was diagnosed with a rare myxofibrosarcoma. I had surgeries in May, June, and July. I removed the sarcoma. Radiation afterwards. I'm going to skip a little bit here. I share my experience only to put a spotlight on the hardships that basically every veteran can suffer. There are places to get help. Register for the burn pits. Seek counseling if needed. There are confidential hotlines. The county courthouses in Chippewa and Claire have, great veteran resources if you need someplace to find assistance. That's my story. I would change nothing except for the cancer. Everything I've endured has helped me become the man, the husband, the dad, the father, the son, the brother I am today. Every veteran in this room has their own story. Many were not welcomed home the same way we were. Still, today, some struggle with PTSD, their own cancers, and worse. Please honor them on this day and every day for their sacrifice, their courage, selfless service, contributions to this great country. I'll leave with this. My wife, Christy, is a principal at Regis Middle School and High School. She got a call early this week from a Vietnam vet. He was upset Regis was not doing a veterans program this year. There were scheduling conflicts and didn't allow them to have a program this year. The veteran was very upset because this was his time to publicly recognize his son, who currently is in the military, and give him the recognition his son deserved that he did not receive himself when he came home. My wife tried to explain the reasoning, but the veteran stated clearly she didn't understand the importance of Veterans Day. My wife kindly told him about me, and the call ended with that. Tell your husband thank you for his service. God bless.
Thank you.
Mrs. Mary Ellen Grossinger.
Thank you.
Thank you. You may be seated. At this time, we would like to do the drawing for the metal decor that was donated by the Tech Ed Department. First winner is Pat Paul. Students that have lunch aid are asked to remain in the bleachers. Other students are asked to